Your friendly neighborhood Slip Gator here, hanging out today, doing stuff and things on the Ark Survival Evolved Pooping Evolved server. Hope you guys are having a good day. I'm having a really good day. Just was hanging out on the server. There's a new update. We're going to be doing some update stuff and things today. I'm really excited about it. But I noticed this little lady out here, level 12 Stego. And you know, from a few episodes ago, we had the great Alpha Carno attack of 2015, and it came in and decimated our supply. So I actually did tame up a male Stego last night as well. I just found him hanging out. Let's give you some more food, homie. And we still have two ladies. We got two ladies just hanging out doing their thing over here and over here, like a so. Oh, wait, why don't you... Somebody must be logging on. When people log on the server, we get a little bit of lag. But anyway, so they're hanging out. So I want to continue to get RG kibble. I want to have a bunch of it, maybe like a couple hundred or something like that. So we definitely need a little bit more. So we had this little lady out here. I had Brawler out this morning. I was just taking out my guy, getting some levels on him. He's up to 186 now. I got him up to just over 2,000 health and started pumping his melee damage as well. So yeah, we're going to let this guy hang out and do his tamey stuff and things. And today we're going to play around some other stuff. I think we're going to try to tame some. We're going to try to breed some Argents today. The new mammal breeding stuff and things have come out. And it's pretty unbelievable. There's a lot of things that you can breed now. And the mammal breeding has started. So we can do, what is it? We can do these guys now, right? We can do mammoths. Yeah, enable wandering to mate. So we can do those guys, and we can do RGs as well. Can we mate pretzels? Get out of the way, Brawler Tail! Pretzel. Oh, no way! You can mate pretzels? That's super huge, big news, guys. Pretzels are so hard to find. It's going to be so much easier to do breeding on them. Oh, my gosh. This might be a thing that we need to... I only have the one female. I don't know if anybody on the server has a dude. If somebody has a dude... That would be a big deal. So we could take a look at that today as well. All right. But what I wanted to... Oh, yeah. I wanted to start off. I want to make sure I take a second to say thank you, guys. It's like I'm talking to Brawler. Hey, Brawler. Thanks so much. I want to take a second to make sure I tell you guys. Thank you very, very much for all your likes and support. Nice comments on the videos. I really do appreciate it. So, yeah. If you guys hit the... if you guys like the video, please don't forget to smash the like button. If you haven't already, don't forget to subscribe for more Ark stuff and things and Mad Max stuff and things and all sorts of other stuff and things. I do have a couple of announcements to make real quick. We're doing a banner contest. If you guys didn't check it out, just Google like Slipgator or you do a YouTube search, Slipgator 500,000 subscriber special. We're doing a banner contest. I've talked about it a couple of times where you guys can submit banners to slipgator.com/artcomp. We're looking for layered files, preferably PNGs. That are non-game specific, so Slipgator specific, but not about Ark games, not about Minecraft games, just about something like Slipgatory, and just show your creativity off, and you submit them there. We're going to have three winners. We're going to post those banners to the YouTube channel, the Twitter feed, and the Facebook page. And yeah, so that's just a fun thing that you guys can do if you'd like to. I think we're going to run the contest through the end of the month. So on the 31st will be like the last day that we take submissions. And then I'm going to be on vacation coming up here. So when I get back, we'll probably do that and I'll announce the winners and all of that. So another thing, another quick announcement, just to let you guys know, vacation times are coming up for me. I don't really take time off very much. I normally work pretty much all day, 7 days a week. And I don't mind it. It's fun. But I do need to be able to take time off every once in a while. So me and my wife are going to Florida and to visit some friends. And so for the next couple of weeks, guys, just keep in mind that things might be a little bit different. There might not be videos of Ark every single day. I'm going to try to make sure that that happens. But you may notice that there's a little less videos going out. Because like right now, I do 2 and 3 videos a day like that. So in order to make sure I can still have content for you for the whole time, what I do is for a week before the week I'm gone, I kind of like double up and try to do a lot of extra videos so that there'll still be videos when I'm away. So yeah, just something to keep in mind, guys. So today, moving on. What level are you? What level are you? 20? Why are you level 20? No one wants a 20. Get out of here, level 20. Now we've got wild Argentavis food on the ground. So, all right. Here's something I want to check out. You know, it's been a while since I've enabled wandering on a bird. So let's just go ahead and see here. Do you fly when wandering is enabled, or do you just walk around? I think they just walk around.
Walking around, that's right.
So, all right, let's disable wandering and go ahead and grab tonnage. So tonnage and poundage are dude and lady, I'm just going to tell you. And I think I've seen T-Rex egg. Sorry, I got really excited. I think I've seen a little bit of a love connection. I'm not going to lie. I think I've seen these guys kind of looking at each other, kind of, you know, making eyes at each other. They hang out all the time. I mean, it's kind of inevitable, you know what I mean? They're the only dude and the only lady RG around here. Well, except for stupid Big Pigeon, but he doesn't really count. And so I'm thinking we're going to try to get... RG egg! Oh my god, so many eggs. This is so great. So I think we're going to try to get these guys to see if they're going to make a love connection. So we're going to stick them inside the room over here, the special breeding Humpy Time room, and see what kind of hot Humpy Time action we can get out of these guys. Let's go ahead and close the door. Enable wandering. Enable wandering. All right, do it. Do it right now, mate! They're not mating. Are you guys not ready? It looks like they're eyeballing each other. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, something's happening. Why aren't they moving? Oh, I thought enable wandering. I thought I did this. Enable wandering. Why are you not wandering? Wander. Oh, they're harding. Which one's the lady? Who's the lady again? There it is. She's the lady. All right, come over here. All right, here they come. Here. Oh, love connection. Love connection. Oh, love connection. Oh, love connection failed. Okay. Oh, love connection, love connection, love connection. Oh, they're doing it. They're doing it while they move around. That's really crazy. I didn't know birds could mate while walking. This is an amazing power that these birds have. So you can see the mating bars going up. They're definitely into it. You can see. They're very much... It's not like... they're very excited. You can tell. It's not like eagles, where eagles mate in the air, I think, and then almost fall to their death or something like that. And then they also exchange nest-like rings. And there's vows, and there's like eagle priests and the whole thing. They go to the eagle church, which is just the sky. But yeah, so he just pooped while mating. That's disgusting, Tunnage. You don't... I mean, maybe it's in their culture. I don't know. Oh, they're really going at it now. The progress bar is smoking. All right, we're going to wait for them to complete their... I don't want you to see the finishing, the whole thing. I just want... We'll just wait. We'll come back here in just a moment. And we're back. And actually, they did get to a point where they were too far away from each other. And they stopped breeding, which is no bueno at all. I mean, that means that we've got like a major, major problem with this breeding facility that we've got over here. It's too big. So... I guess we can try to see if it'll just work again. Hopefully they don't get too far away from each other. But that's something to think about. So something like this, in case you were building your breeding area and you had it like one behemoth gate by one behemoth gate, kind of like this, this may not work for you. Something a little smaller may be necessary. I'm going to see if they'll still get it done before I build something different or put a wall up or something like that. We're going to see if maybe they'll still get it. All right. I'm going to keep an eye on them and I'll BRBs, peeps. Oh, here it comes, squirt out a baby, yes, what is it, too hot, okay, pick it up, all right, what's the temperature here, 93 Fahrenheit, all right, makes sense, way too hot, you guys did such a great job, good job, guys, let me go ahead, no, just hold on over here, disable wandering, all right, are you not wandering, and would you listen to what I tell you? You're not wandering anymore. All right. So we'll let these guys do their thing. We'll keep them in there for now. Whatever. All right. I'm going to head over. I don't know what the temperature is on these, and I know they're different for each egg. I'm going to get on the double, and I'm going to head over to Poop City back to my house because that was a good spot to do it, you know, the way we did it last time. And I'm going to see if that's a good spot for us to incubate our RG egg. I can't wait to have an RG baby. And we're back at Poop City. It is currently 72 degrees. Let us drop our egg here and see what happens. Too hot. Okay. All right. So 70 degrees is too hot as well. Kind of makes sense. Good to know, but it kind of makes sense because the RGs are kind of like mountain type creatures. So I'm thinking maybe they need to be in a little colder environment, maybe up a little bit higher. Let's head to the top of the volcano right here. Shouldn't take us but a moment in order to get up here. and see if this area will do it. I'm just checking the temperature. We're up to 42 degrees. Oh, suddenly now it's 70. Is it going to get colder when we get up here? It should get pretty cold. What? 71, 72. Oh, we're loading in all of the stuff and things here. I don't know if you guys have seen this. Oh my God, Ark. So, Mazion has a little forge area up on the top of on top of the volcano here. 74. Okay, it's way too hot here. Let's go ahead and take a moment and rest. Turn the gamma down a little bit. Maybe we gotta go to somewhere super cold. I'm thinking like around 40 degrees. I'm thinking that the northwest is probably going to be too cold, but we can try it. We can try that. So I'm going to head over to Drax's like temporary base and see if it's too cold over there. And we're back at the Drax base. I didn't bring my fur armor, so it's a little bit chilly here for me. Can I walk through there? All right, park our guy inside of there. Let's head in the house. At least this way, we might be able to get a house buff. Okay, no. All right, so let's just go ahead and take a look here. Too cold. Okay, and this is 27 degrees Fahrenheit. So, does he have any fireplaces around here anywhere? No, he just has the industrial grill. All right, so too cold here. I'm thinking maybe in the 40s is what we're looking for. I'm going to take a wild guess and say that's probably it. I don't know if we've got... What I'm trying to look for is somebody, someplace that's got a base already existing, so I don't have to build something. But we may have to build a little enclosure or something like that just to make sure that we're safe. Now, you know, one of the things is I don't think that mobs attack the eggs. I don't know if that's the case, but I doubt it. Let's take a look here. All right, 46. Let's just go ahead and find a spot, a safe spot somewhere around right here. Is there a safe spot? Can we even find one? Okay, this looks fairly safe. I just don't want to get attacked and have it be a big thing. Oh, there's an RG right there. What level are you, homie? Can I see you? I can't see you, of course. Level 20. Okay, we can easily remedy the situation. You want some? You got some. All right. 46 degrees. Too cold. So 46 degrees is too cold. Crap. All right, so now we know we're in between 71 and 46. I'm thinking... I mean, gosh. I don't know if there is even a spot that's, like, in there. All right, 47. I know that... I mean, when you change temperature zones, it's, like, so drastic. It happens, like, just in an instant. This is Softus's spot. 47... Still 47. Okay. Let's check and see. Does he have any fireplaces around? There he is! So I'm looking for a spot where he's got some fireplaces. There's one right here. You got any fuel in there? No. Okay. Can we... Whip its box. Soft its box. You know what? That almost looked like a baby trike for a second. I need... Oh my God, their barn is humongous. I need some wood really quickly. So let's just pop up over here. Where'd my pick go? What? I must have been repairing it and it didn't grab it. Don't need it anyway. Let's go ahead over here really quick. Just grab this tree. All right, 44 wood. We're good to go there. Look at all the super purple dinosaurs. They look amazing. I love those guys. All right, let's pop over into here. Let us go like so. Too cold. Incubating! It's incubating! All right, it's working. So 47 degrees plus a fire is what we're looking at right here. I wish that the little thing was easier to see for you guys. Because if I can't... There we go. You can just barely see it there. Incubating and you can see the egg health is good. So we're going to sit right here. I actually pull the double inside. We're going to utilize Soft's and Whippet's base and we're going to hang out here and watch our egg become an argy. BRBs, peeps. And we're back. Softus is here with his guard dog. And the temperature has dropped drastically. It is now 33 degrees Fahrenheit, which is too cold to incubate our egg. So I have used the Slipgator patented pick up your egg method. And we're very close. But we're very, very close to the end of the incubation period. I also may have borrowed several stacks of meat from Softus' dinosaurs. Because I was a little bit ill-prepared. Good. Which we will replace. We will replace. I have just the double here, and he's not the best fighter of all time. He flies. He looks like a fighter. He flies like a fighter jet. But he is not the best fighter ever with his... Oh, well, 500% melee damage. Yeah, anyway. So we are waiting for the temperature to rise. Oh, it's going down even more now. But this doesn't make sense. It's the middle of the day. Whoa, look at him go. So... It is, well, approaching night, is it not? It is 1749, so it's in the evening. It's almost time for dinner. So we're just, oh, 23, it's freezing. I'm hypothermic. No, this base is terrible. All right, now I feel better. This base is not terrible, I'm just joking. So I'm going to, oh no, I'm freezing. Okay, we're better. I'm going to wait for the day, for the temperature to rise. And we will be our bees. And we're back. The temperature is rising. Oh, we're at 35 degrees. And Softus just said it was cool if I went out and grabbed some meat on this guy. Check out this guy's stats, man. What is this guy's name? Rexy? 14, almost 15,000 hit points, 2,000 stamina, 2,000 melee damage. It was getting huge amounts of meat. It's crazy. It's been really cold, so I'm a little bit hurt. But all right, now over here, let's take a look here and see what we got going on. So we're up to 35 degrees. Let us drop our egg. Too cold. Okay. So the temperature is going to continue to rise. Oh, wait. It's at 34. That's really weird. It went down to 27. Now it's turning night, and the temperature's going back up at night. So I'm just going to hang out in here, I guess. Okay, now it's going down again. So we got to just wait for daytime. So I'm going to wait for day. We'll get the egg incubated up. I figured I'd just let you know where all the meat was coming from, though. So we got all this meat right here. Huge, huge amounts. And there's more over on the Rexy Rex as well. So, all right. Wait for the temperature to rise. And we're back. I'm bringing you back to the video for some egg science. What I have learned is the Argentavis eggs. Minimum incubation temperature with the assistance of a campfire is 42 degrees Fahrenheit. Now, if you live in a country where you don't use an antiquated temperature measurement system such as Fahrenheit, it's like a million Kelvin or five heat things. I don't know what it is in Celsius. I don't know, but I'm just saying it's 42 degrees Fahrenheit. The incubation is happening. Basically, what I did was I was waiting here in the morning and just holding the H button. And every time the temperature increased by a degree, I would place the egg down. Then I would use the scientific method of looking at the bar that said too cold. And then if it was too cold, I would pick it up. And so we've been doing that for quite a while. And 42 degrees Fahrenheit with the campfire is the name of the name of the game. Oh, Mazion just killed a 120 saber. We were talking about in the chat what we're looking for, and I said, you know, he's asking if we're looking for 120 Argents. I said, 120 anything, and he said, oh, I found a 106 Argent, and I said, no, I'm looking for 120 anythings, and then he said, I killed a 120 saber. But that happens. It happens all the time. Our egg's going to hatch. Oh, my God, a baby Argentavis imprint. Oh, we've imprinted. Poundage, tonnage, Ouncy? Is that how you spell ouncy? I don't know. He's so little and amazingly cute. Oh my God. Will you go away, stupid text screen? Please make it so I can hide it all the time. Oh my gosh. Look how amazingly small. Oh wait, he's gonna die. Oh wait, we have to feed it. Oh my God, I was so confused for a second. I forgot we had to feed it. I was overcome by its cuteness. It's amazing cuteness. It's so amazingly cute and small. I can't believe how small it is. Okay, he's not eating very fast. He's not eating nearly as fast as the T-Rex. Oh, this is much better. This is much more. This is much better and amazing. Okay, we can put this out now. So that's good. Can we get you back onto follow? He's following me. Let's watch him walk. Come over here, buddy. Oh, look at him go. He's this little walking. He's one day. Come to daddy. Come here, buddy. Come here, buddy. You can do it. Where are you? He's not that. Okay. He's not that far. Come on. Come over here. Come over here. What? Come here. I wish you could, like, pick him up. I need to pick him up. Oh, he's got... Look, he's already got more weight. His baby's... Baby's first extra stacks of meat. Baby's first extra stacks of meat. Oh, my God. He's so amazingly cute. I wonder if I can pick him up. I don't think you can pick him up with a pteranodon. We got to get him out of here. Let's maybe go like this. Get this guy. Are you coming over here? Come over here. No, make a turn. Left turn. Look how big it is compared to the dodo. No, over here, buddy. Where are you? Why are you going that way? What are you following? You're supposed to be following me. Are you mentally not so great? I hope you're not. I hope you're smart. Oh, wow. Is he burdened? Yep. You can't even move, stupid frog. He's inside the frog now. I gotta get him out. Is he stuck? Oh, there he comes! Oh, he's gonna walk through poop. No, don't walk through poop. Oh, God, he's gonna be all poop. Where are you going? I feel like maybe he's not so bright. He's very small, though, so he'll grow. And when his brain grows, maybe he'll grow a brain that's better. And it'll be a smarter brain. And we'll all rejoice at the smartness of its brain. So also, one of the other things, Softus's base is like perfect for Argy's because he does have feeding troughs like right here. So we can continue the growth of our little buddy, Ouncy. Look how amazingly cute he is! Do you have enough food? Are you hungry? Do you want something? I'll give you food. Oh, get all your food from there! Oh my God, so cute! So the maturation progress is going to take quite a bit of time. What do we got over inside of here? So he's got meat galore. Well, ones of meat galore. Berries galore. What do we got over here? More berries galore. And more ones of meat galore. Which we can use, you know, once he's bigger. Oh my God. You put more meat on him here. I have all the meat. Buddy, eat it up. You want some? You want some? You like it? You like it? He's so cute. I can't even believe it. Look how small he is compared to us. It's so amazing. Oh my God, I can't get over it. All right, I know. No, wait, I'm trying to, there we go, stand up. Stand up, Slipgator. If we go like this, check this out, guys. Oh, so cute. So small and so cute. Amazing. Oh, it's amazing how cute he is and how tiny. I can't even believe it. I'm overcome with this cuteness. All right, so the process of growing the baby has begun. We will grow him. And then we will... we'll BRB at the different growth stages, peeps. Right now, he's a baby Ouncy. And when he gets a little bit bigger, I'll bring you back. And we're back. We're about to try something out. I want to see if we can pick up this baby RG with Pugly. So I got him out here. He's a juvenile now, so it doesn't really change. It looks like he is a little bit bigger, but you can see he's gone on to wandering mode, which is really silly. I'm not sure exactly why it is that's a thing. He should be not wandering now. Is there a reason why you're still wandering even though you're not a wandering? All right, so here we go. Yeah, I don't understand why they have it so that updates every time to wandering, especially when you can just whistle one to follow and then it disables that. But anyway, so let's see if we can pick him up. Oh, crap. So we could pick up the baby Rex, which was really sweet. Now, you can't pick up a regular RG with one of these guys. We'll try another time just to see. No, it doesn't look like we can. Let me see. See if he can try to pick it up. So it doesn't look like you can pick these guys up. So you can pick up the baby Rexes, which is kind of interesting. So, all right, cool. That's cool. All right, so we just got our baby now. So what we're going to do is we're just going to have him follow us back inside just so he's safe. Look how little he is. Like, anything could kill it. I don't want anything to kill it. How many HPs do you have, buddy? 324. So he's getting there. Place it on my Quetzal and ride it home? How can I place it? It can't fly. I don't think it can fly. There's no way it can fly. Does it fly? Because if it flies, then that would just be the most adorable thing of all time. No, it can't fly. There may be a stage in its growth where it can. Oh, I'm out of cooked meat. But right now, it doesn't look like that's the case. So we're going to move him back inside. And we're just going to wait for him to grow up to see. I'm going to see, actually, if there's any point, too, at which it starts to fly before it's fully grown. I'm interested to see if that's a thing, too. And we're back with a little update. Ouncey's an adolescent. Let me show you here how big he is now. He's getting quite a bit bigger. Not as big as a full-grown RG or anything like that, but he's pretty close. He's about halfway grown, and I have been checking to see if there's a point at which in his, you know, growth stage, juvenile, adolescent, all that he'll fly. And it doesn't look like that's the case. Like, he just won't fly. He's at adolescent now, so he's just not flying. I don't think he's going to fly until he's full-grown. Mazion needed a RG saddle, so he came over, and we crafted one up. And actually, he brought over enough materials for two. I don't know a lot of saddles. I only know a couple, actually, just the Ichthy and RG and a couple others. But I knew this one anyway. So we built two, and now I've got one on Ouncey right here. Like you can see, so when he is ready to go, which is going to be a while yet, we'll be ready to go. So I'm going to keep him inside just to keep him safe. I really wish he would fly at some point. I think that would be really cool, but for now, this is what we're going to do. Also, you may have noticed that there is a trike boneskin helmet in my inventory. That's right, ladies and gentle peeps. We were hanging out here. I was hanging out over here. Let me go ahead and get this guy on follow so he doesn't wander around. I was hanging out in this base, and Softest and Whippet's base is so big that there are spawns all around here. Well, guess what? An alpha T-Rex spawned up in the corner over here or somewhere near there. I can't tell if it was inside the base or outside the base. There's a little area up over here where, like, the base, the wall kind of doesn't cover where these rocks are right there. See how you can see there's that gap? And inside this gap, it was kind of in the middle. It wasn't really inside the base. It wasn't really outside the base. It was kind of, like, right here. There was an Alpha T-Rex. He was only level, I think it was 8, so he was pretty low. So I grabbed that Super Rex that I borrowed earlier, the one that has like 20,000 health and 15,000 health, I think, and 2,000 melee damage. And Maz was here too, and we took it out really quickly. It had some decent stuff on it, Journeyman Crossbow. I think the Journeyman Crossbow was probably about the best thing. But we're kind of past all that as far as, like, I don't even carry any crossbows anymore. We just carry rifles. So I think, we got fighting wars. There's fighting wars happening. Is it over here? See, there's like Sabertooth and stuff that spawned in here. It's such a dangerous base. But, oh, these guys can mate now, too, I think, by the way. The Carnotaurs. I wonder when Brian and Jessica get back from the honeymoon, they're going to have a baby, too. Oh, it's going to be so exciting. I can't wait. But, all right, so just to give you the update, the size of the bird is increasing. We still have quite a ways to go before the maturation process is complete. I will also let you know that the RGs take way less. I may have already said this before, but they take way less meat. Way less meat. I'm pretty sure that the Rex that we did took at least 3 full feeding troughs full of meat. And I filled this one up, and you can see that it's pretty slow. It doesn't really eat meat that quick, which is nice. You could AFK the maturation progress on your RG, no problems, peeps. So, all right, I guess we're just going to wait for that final stage with that little update, and then we'll BRBs, peeps.
I wonder what noise they make when they get all grown up. Is it like, caw-caw, caw-caw? Or like, whippoorwill, whippoorwill.
He made his thing, and Ouncey is the thing. He's a guy, and we can put a saddle on him now. And he's our little buddy. And you know what? I don't think we ever really talked about the statistics on this guy. So 1, or 1450 health,
2925 stamina. Really, really high. The weight is 532. Melee damage is already 420 right out the gate. So he's 179th level. Now, I'm kind of trying to think about what like level a perfect tame would be and what level this guy is. And, you know, I was just thinking about like how the breeding works and everything. And, you know, one of the things I think would be really, really great is if there was some sort of tool or some sort of way that we could know what this guy came from, what his heritage and stock was. I think that would be really, really cool. So that, because right now, I think, I mean, at this point, if you're not tracking the statistics of your birds at the beginning, like from when you tame them, there's no real way to tell, is this going to be a big problem? Are you going to be in my butt, up my butt the whole time? Pugly? Pugly, don't come in my butt. Don't come up my butt. That sounded terrible. So that thing, that would be a really cool addition to the Seven Things. But this is our first breeded Argentavis, and he is unbelievably cool. I think we're going to make him into kind of an everything bird. Get out of stop putting your beak in my butt, stupid. That's disgusting. Go. Why can't you just follow? Why is it's not like beyond me? It's follow. It's not. I don't whistle you beyond me. I just whistle you follow. But I think we're gonna make him into an everything bird. We may give back, stupid big pigeon to Drax, and thank you very much for helping out. But I think this video is going long. I hope you guys don't mind that. But we did breed our RG and had a really good time. We did find some science out about that the babies can't fly and what the temperatures are good for our incubating the Exors. And that's going to be it for today, peeps. Stay tuned next time. Tomorrow, I do believe me and Maz are going to get together and play around some stuff and things. Get out of my butt! So if you like-